Oh, sir. It was kind.
I'm about to show my naivete here, but I didn't think they'd do it. I didn't think they would be so cheap, lazy, and creatively cowardly to do it. But they were, and they did, and for me it spoils what was an otherwise highly entertaining and fairly spectacular romp. It's Khan. Khan Noonien motherfucking Singh. If that name means nothing to you, then you'll probably really enjoy this film. If that name is, to you, synonymous with Seti Alpha 5, The Kobayashi Maru, and Paradise Lost, then I strongly suspect your face will be as bruised as mine from the facepalm. The thing that makes it harder to accept the bullshit that is Khan is that this is not a bad film. For a start, the casting of the crew is spot on. Carl Urban in particular couldn't be more like DeForest Kelly if he tried, and Zachary Quinto often steals the show as Spock. And for all my impending bitching, Benedict Cumberbatch was very convincing as a bad guy. I think he does lack the calm menace of Ricardo Montalban, but it was nevertheless good to see what the term super soldier actually means. Peter Weller is also very good as Admiral Marcus. Murphy may be looking a bit old, but he's still a bit of a badass. Something I do like about this reimagining is that the people feel like people. They aren't perfect, they aren't saints, they swear, they fight, and they're not above revenge. Roddenberry might be turning in his grave, but in all honesty, the almost smug perfection of his future humans has always rubbed me up the wrong way. Which is probably why I find Sisko to be the best captain. Visually, the film is quite the feast. The effects are really less than superb, and I really did like the overall aesthetic of Starfleet. But one thing I still don't like is the Enterprise itself, or more specifically, the nacelles and the props holding the nacelles up. Now, I can see what I suspect they were trying for, a halfway house between the 60s era ship and the 70s to 90s era ship, but they just don't look right. The film has a very quick pace with action coming thick and fast, and for the most part the action is wonderful. Anything involving ships is fast and fluid, although I did think there was overuse of hull breach, people being sucked into space! Yes, that would happen, but much like with shit sparking on the bridge, overuse deadens the impact. And as with this film's predecessor, any fight involving fisticuffs is frenetic and brutally hard-hitting. I mean, as I suggested earlier, Khan is an absolute badass. Yes, it annoys me it's Khan, but getting to see just why it is he and his followers were so feared during the eugenics war was, I must admit, joyous. But one thing that I loved, loved, loved about this film was the appearance of the Klingons. I love the Klingons. They have such great potential both as allies and enemies, and their appearance here, it was the first time I have ever found them to be truly sinister, and it was wonderful. The biggest disappointment for me, not counting Khan, was the ending. Large elements of it were telegraphed ridiculously early, and it ended up being exceptionally cheap. In fact, I think I will go so far as to say that the ending felt like it belonged on a television show. It was a cheap, predictable reset button, and it was not worthy to lick the warp coils of the film that it tried to ape. What I liked about Star Trek 09 was that they had the balls to wipe Vulcan off the map and not have it magically reappear at the end. And I think that's my biggest disappointment with Star Trek Into Darkness. It lacks balls. What they did in Star Trek 09 was necessary to break away from 40 years of often contradictory canon, and this was the chance to take Star Trek somewhere interesting, to come up with new villains and new problems, to take it, if they so desired, into darkness. Now, I can't say that this is a bad film, because it's not. It's fast, funny, and action-packed, the acting and effects are brilliant, and it sets up one or two potentially amazing things. But I have been a Star Trek fan since I was a boy. Phrases like,
one day, one night, Kobayashi Maru.
Bones.
and...
I have been, and always shall be, your friend.
...have a great deal of resonance for me. Names like Sarika Vulcan and Khan Noonien Singh conjure up images of some of the best moments in Star Trek. The current keepers of Trek haven't quite fucked it up yet, but I just hope that the next Star Trek film spends less time plundering what has gone before and actually does explore strange new worlds. If you're a non-Trek fan, there is a considerable amount to like, and the things that annoyed me probably won't annoy you. If you're a long-term Star Trek fan, well, consider yourself warned.